in this episode, telescope restoration. Right, so I purchased this Saxon Dobsonian 8-inch just a few days ago, and just want to show you its condition at this stage. So it does move in azimuth. A lot of dust, no rust, just a lot of cleaning. There you go, the mirror's got a whole lot of dust on it. Need to clean that up. Focus looks fine. Got a Crayford style focuser. I have the other pieces, I'll bring them in a minute. And rotates pretty smoothly in altitude. But it does not do any rotation in azimuth, barely. And if you look closely, you'll see where the wood has expanded, because it looks like it's been exposed to some moisture. So those two bases will need to be rebuilt out of timber. However, overall, I think we've got a really good restoration project. And from here, we'll take off these rocker boxes from the base and we'll cut out a new base. And here's a bag of goodies it came with. There's finder scope. These are really high quality scopes. Just needs to be cleaned up. Here we have the tightening handles, which go in there. An eyepiece, which you can barely see through because there's so much dust, but no scratches. Other bits and bobs. And looks like a moon filter, screwdriver, and some more lids. What I did notice was missing was that usually there's some sort of a lid that sits on top here, so we can just make that out of plastic or plywood. The finder scope holder or finder scope bracket seems to be in good condition as well, so I'm not going to worry about that. And while we're at it, we'll just take off these three rubber feet. Clean that little bit of rust, dry it off, and then make a new base. In fact, what we can do with this base is keep it for the time being, so you can make the new template and drill the holes in the precise locations. And then we can go and copy it across to our new base. And here's a close up of the rocker box. Like I said, looks like it's in a pretty good nick. I just need to give it a really good clean. Remove the dust and we'll just put it aside until I can find some timber to build two new bases. Try and replicate the original design as much as possible, so just take some measurements of the radius. So now during this COVID pandemic, we've got to find a way to buy some timber, noting that all the hardware stores are closed and it's only open for trading, so I might have to do some dumpster diving to find some wood. During my dumpster diving, I managed to find 12mm MDF with a hole cut out of it. However, I can still use it for the base. And I also happen to have some 10mm MDF in the garage, which I'll use for the bottom board of the rocker body. Now we'll just go out and
those pieces. So I've cut the bottom board of the rocker body. Now we'll just drill some holes and then mount it to the remainder of the rocker body.
I actually like these finder scopes. They're quite sturdy and image quality is pretty good. I've managed to already clean the lenses whilst recording a low quality video. So I'm going to make another video of how I take it all apart and I'll put it back together. So you'll not see me clean the lenses because that's already done. However, you'll see me take this apart and then put it back together, just that you know.
Thank you. base, and I've just installed the telescope temporarily, and as you can see, it slides really well. So I can even push it at 45 degrees and I get very little issues, and it's very smooth. So from here, I'll be taking off the telescope and taking the primary mirror and giving it a good clean. There you go, dirty mirror. However, there appear to be no scratches, which means we have some hope. This thing's been out of it for a while. I mean, I'm gonna have to be very gentle to get some of those slightly bigger pieces off. That's why we're soaking it in soap for as long as possible. And with a soaked cotton wool, gently very gently apply a little bit of pressure, literally the weight of the soaked cotton wool is enough. Look at that. There is the reflective surface. And we'll just flush it with some deionized water. Keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going. That's enough, thank you. Okay, so the telescope is set up, ready to go. We have a working base. We've got a working focuser. The eyepieces have been cleaned. The mirror has been cleaned as well. So now it's about time to take it observing.
And just turn the flash on here temporarily. And up in the sky you'll see the moon, Jupiter, and Saturn's just ahead. It's going to be hard to show you through the eyepiece, so I'll just give it a shot. If anything, we'll definitely capture the moon.
Pretty good. And thanks for watching. See you next time.